Hi, I'm Jan Henning from FlippedNormals.com, and today's video is going to be a little bit different. This is the start of, I think, what we're calling our challenge series, where Henning and I will battle it out in ZBrush, and we'll be sculpting something. We'll be given something to sculpt, and we have an hour to do it, and whoever comes out on top is going to be the winner. And that's something for you guys to decide. We are at your mercy, and we'll see how this goes, I guess. One thing I wanted to mention is, remember that we have a Black Friday sale going on right now. 50% off all FlippedNormals exclusives, and over 30,000 products are actually on sale for this Black Friday event.
All right, so the challenge for today is sculpting a camel from memory. The rules: you must sculpt a full body realistic camel purely from memory. You have 60 minutes to complete the challenge. You're not allowed to see each other's screens. The ruling: when the 60 minutes are up, you can reveal your results to each other. You will be judged based on how much your camel looks like a camel, and the winner is decided by the audience. So I should be off. That should be fun. Should be really interesting.
Yeah, we didn't know we were sculpting until a couple of minutes ago when my wife told us. So that should be interesting. And we have no reference for any of this, so we're doing it purely from memory. And we have no idea, collectively, I think, what a camel sort of really looks like, you know.
Guess we just get started with that. Should we do a timer? Time countdown? All right. 3, 2, 1.
Go.
Go. All right. Minutes have started. I am going to try to make this from a C-sphere and make an awesome camel.
So I actually have a confession to make. Henning and I did actually record another version of this where it was a horse. And right as we were finishing up, everything was good to go. We found out that there was an issue on our end, so we had to kind of scrap the entire recording, which is a little bit sad.
And we realized we couldn't do it again, because now we looked in the video, we looked at reference of what a horse looked like, and now we kind of know, not like very well, but
reasonably well, like well enough that it would be different this time.
Yeah, I know they have big legs.
Big legs, like the really big feet. Wide feet, so they can stand on sand, right? So
yeah,
we've got that going for us.
They have ears, good, so far, so good. This is an interesting one, because like the other one, doing a horse, we kind of have some general ideas here, but now I feel like we have to just help each other to remember what features does it have.
Exactly.
Okay, so do you know how many humps a camel has?
One. Right, because that's the other one that's not a camel that has two, I think.
I think it's the opposite.
Oh, crap.
But I don't know. Because I made a memory rule about this some time ago.
Oh, yeah?
That a camel is just a camel, but a dromedary has like, it's like the D on the back for dromedary. It just has like one thing on the back. But this might not be true.
Oh, okay. I'll go with one then, and then okay. We'll see.
Okay, so one of us is going to be correct, yeah. Maybe. What does a camel face look
yeah,
like?
Yeah, I know they have like really long eyelashes.
I saw camels in Turkey last year.
Yeah,
we were in an area called Cappadocia, all the way up in there. They're like.
Then you have an advantage.
Yeah, because I did see a camel 20 meters a year and a half ago. I know that they have like feet, like toes. Like they don't. I'm pretty sure they're not walking on like their hooves or something, or maybe it's called hooves. But I don't think it's like a nail. I think anatomically, they're like they have like actual, like I don't know what a paw. I don't know what.
Probably not a paw. But wait, what do? I mean, camels must have ears, obviously. But what do? Where are they?
Oh, but they have these. Don't they have? I was gonna say, don't they have these horns as well? But those are giraffes.
Oh yeah, that's a different animal.
Yeah, that's a different animal. But if a giraffe has horns, why couldn't a camel have horns? I think the ears are going outwards.
Okay.
That is based on absolutely nothing. Maybe they're going like downwards. They're probably going a bit downwards.
I feel like this could be camel shaped or a llama. That's fairly similar though, right? Like a llama and a camel. They kind of have the same...
Basically same
isn't
thing.
Isn't that like... Isn't that their humps? It's like really high up or something?
Oh, like is it humps now or a hump?
Their hump. the humps of the camels, as in because there are multiple camels.
got it. Jesus Christ, what does a camel face look like? Like, I think their noses are really weird. I seem to remember that, but I don't know what that means. That their noses are snouts are weird. I just know that maybe I can just kind of try different things and see what my brain kind of
comes up with.
Likes. Really just trying out a lot of different things and seeing what my brain recognizes as a camel.
I've never seen a camel in real life, so.
Oh, that definitely. I wouldn't even say that arc hurts you compared to me, because it's not like I have extensive camel experience in real life.
Extensive camel experience.
All the London camels walking around here.
Is that right? Does it break like that, or have I broken its leg now? Like, I might have broken its legs. What about you? Where are you at?
I actually have no idea what's going on. It's to the point I genuinely don't know where this is going. It's so far away from anything uncomfortable with sculpting.
Yeah.
If this was like a giraffe, then it would be game over for you, Morten. But since it's a camel, then.
Now I have a chance.
Yeah, that's lucky.
That's Steph. Oh, okay, there was something there.
You're onto something?
Yeah, maybe a camel is like it is kind of like a horse, right? I feel like this looks... Okay, I feel like something's happening here. You know what? I'm actually feeling quite confident about this one. Except for the whole broken leg thing. I feel like the shape, the silhouette is kind of like camel-like.
Okay, that's good.
Maybe?
Some vain in confidence there. I have a bit of a front leg and hind leg and a neck and head and lump and hump situation. There's a bit of a multifaceted issue on my end here. Do you know what the ears look like?
Nope, I have no idea. I just dragged out a general triangle looking thing and went with, yeah, that's probably what it is.
Because I'm playing around with them now. I generally don't know if they're going up or down or what they're doing. It's funny because not knowing what you're actually sculpting, I'm just assuming you're doing super well. Because you're like, yeah, this is pretty good. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this.
It's like I'm like a massive victim of the Dunning-Kruger effect right now. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, you know what? This is going pretty well.
Yeah. I have the problem that I'm like kind of doodling around now, but now we have half an hour left, 29 minutes left, and I'm kind of done.
Right.
Like to the point that like it looks like garbage, but I have no more information.
Yeah.
Like I'm done. I've exhausted everything I could potentially know about it. So now it's the turd, and I'm just polishing it. And the shapes could be kind of appealing in the end. You know, if we were to actually just go in and just refine them, the shapes could be appealing. They're just not going to be camel shapes.
Right, yeah.
So let's see how this goes.
Just real quick, do camels have toes?
I think they have toes.
Okay. How many? I'm just putting in a general amount of toes now.
I think it might be three toes. I'm gonna make three. I've made three toes myself.
Okay, I'm going with four then.
Okay, then one of us is my
hump. I have a hump less, and so you know, I'm compensating with toes.
I'm not sure, Morten, that camels have a mane.
Okay.
But that's something we'll figure out in about 22 minutes when we look at some reference here, because also we have 22 minutes left. Because
okay.
It should be judged based on the how good is the camel. But maybe I can like get some popular vote thing going on here where they're like, it doesn't really look like a camel, but
the sculpt is great.
The locks are great. Look at that beautiful, beautiful camel. This is one of the legit one of the worst sculpts I've done since like 2007, I think.
Yeah, but see, okay, here's the thing. In the previous video that's being deleted that people will never see, right? I was, I had no confidence in my horse. And I actually kind of looked like a horse. This time, however, I'm like, I'm pretty confident in my camel. So I think maybe you're doing well.
Yeah. Yeah, you're saying that. I appreciate the confidence, though.
I was like, do they have fangs? No, I don't think they have fangs.
Though with like these kind of animals, I wouldn't be surprised. There's some weird stuff happening when it comes to like
the teeth
of animals like this. Yeah, it would be like, why did you guys quit your jobs in VFX? And we showed them this video here to sculpt desert animals from memory on YouTube.
Really poorly.
Yeah, really, really poorly. And that's why you quit your your positions in the film industry. Your mom will understand.
Yeah.
So I think if you're sculpting a dromedary, then that should be instant disqualification. Because, I mean, I'm just saying.
Whoever has the most correct amount of humps just wins.
I'm just saying, you can't. The criteria is who makes the best camel. And if you're not sculpting a camel... It's a different species.
Yeah, I guess that's a fair point.
Shot into the sun. Jesus Christ. Sometimes I'm looking at it, it's so stupid. Oh man, it's just such a bad sculpt. I don't know how to fix it. Oh man.
It is kind of sculpting with like this kind of handicap where you like, you genuinely, you don't know.
Yeah, generally don't know. Okay, we have 4 minutes now, 4.5.
Oh, jeez. Okay, that was
quick
all of a sudden.
Remember when I said before, like, when I was like, okay, it's 30 seconds left or whatever it was, and I'm done?
You're done,
The sculpt is still fundamentally the same in terms of crappiness, but now it has, like, nice brush strokes on top of it.
Okay,
which
fair enough.
Obfuscates the crappiness to some degree. That's kind of my idea with this, just... I genuinely have nothing more to add because I don't know anything more about the subject I'm sculpting. But, you know.
I think I've made mine too buff now.
I'm very curious what you look like now.
But also, I'm just like approximating shapes now. You know, I'm like, yeah, it feels like there could be a muscle in here. And like, that would make sense. There's like something here. 30 seconds.
Oh, no.
Whatever you gotta do it now.
Can I look at reference?
Aside from that.
Oh, crap. All right. I think I am pretty much... there we go.
There we go. Okay,
turn off the sound.
Oh.
There we go. That was the bell for... we're over.
Oh. Wow. Okay.
All right. Let's do a screen sharing and see what this looks like now. Oh, I see.
You see a butt.
See here, there we go. Oh wow! Yeah, the face though. Yeah, the face definitely reads as a camel. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that because I'm realizing my mistakes now. Because it tapers. I could not figure out what was going on there. And you know, and definitely.
I look at the silhouette and I feel like there's something. But man, those humps. I don't know.
Can you explain the top of the hump? Does it have like a lid or something? Like it looks like a Coke can that you like a hatch that you like open up and you fill with water.
Okay, so I seem to remember that. So like in Japan, like in Japanese folklore, right, they have they have like this little turtle, like the kappas, and they have this bald head with a ring of hair around it, and I feel like it's the same thing with a camel. So I was just trying to like dot in some fur or something.
Well, based on the kappas in Japanese folklore.
Yeah, you know, camel, Japanese, you know, it's one of the same.
I think you're closer than me here, because like my tail is like a otter tail, and your tail looks more like a camel tail. I think your legs are also closer, but with the assumption, well,
it's
with the caveat here, though. with the caveat that we haven't looked at the reference yet.
Oh, yes. Yeah, should we give it a quick peek?
Let's do a little of a Google here.
Okay, you want to bring something up?
Let's do it.
Exciting.
Okay, first, Boo! Oh. They have one, or do they have one? Let's see. I'm not sure. I'm not sure if this is count as one or two. Okay, this is two.
But that's a...
Dromedary. Dromedary has one. But then I want a camel. Camel?
I genuinely don't know. You know, I'll let me just Google it real quick. I think that's the dromedary camel. So a dromedary is also a camel. The dromedary camel has one hump. The Bactrian camel has two humps. So they're both camels. They're just different.
Okay.
It's just a different thing. It's like the same species. Okay, so we're both right. Phew. Okay.
Okay. So then none of us are disqualified then. They do have a little bit of a mane, it seems like.
They do.
They don't.
You've given yours hair, but, you know.
There is that. And in terms of the head, though, like yours is definitely a lot closer.
Closer?
Than closer.
But
like
still.
Because mine doesn't look like a camel.
No.
Mine just looks like a generic animal kind of thing. It looks like, I don't know, an Aragon dragon or something.
Kind of like
this
a goat,
is all over the
a little
place.
Bit from that angle.
Yeah. Yeah.
That is monstrosity.
and I'm definitely making the mistake here as well as I was doing for the horse. Same thing. Here, this distance here is massive. And here it's
tiny.
It is.
It's really... Same with mine. Mine is also way too tiny compared to... the camel. You know, we were going on about the whole, they definitely have big feet and stuff so they can walk in sand, but they don't.
Let's see here. I'm going to bring up...
Actually.
I googled camel feel and I got really sad images. Okay, so they have two toes, it seems like. Where you have here. Looks like they have this. So, you know, it's not terrible here.
I see. Yeah.
I was definitely off by one.
I've given mine four and five. I think it's like it just got out of control. mine aren't even a thing. Like they're just.
But I mean, like pretty fun challenge. Now I enjoy this a lot. Remember to if you enjoy this video and you want to see who declare who the winner will be. Make sure to put your vote in the comments and we'll see who wins this out of these two monstrosities we
and
have
give
created.
Give us suggestions for future topics as well.
Definitely.
Like what we should sculpt. We'll sort of make a decision based on that. I think for the next time, we were talking about getting a sealed envelope from my wife where she reveals it as we're starting the videos. We have no mental prep time either. Not that... Knowing that it's a camel a couple minutes before we start apparently did us any favors, but here we are.
And remember our Black Friday sale as well. Tons of over 30,000 products where all of the FlippedNormals exclusives are on sale. We do have a lot of sculpting courses as well. We don't have anything on camel sculpting, which is pretty apparent.
Which we might need, apparently.
Which we might need. If you have a link to that, let us know. But yeah, tons of cool courses. And very exciting to bring you more content like this in the future.
Yeah, so thank you so much for watching and we'll see you next time.